Hi friends, welcome to Learn with Krishna Sandeep channel. So in this video we are going to see one important program, and I have taken the test this morning, and this is the program they have asked, and it's a product based company. Okay, I don't want to name the company name. It's a product based company based in Hyderabad. It's a mid-sized company with 2000 plus employees. So this is the program they have asked. For the given string, write a program to print the characters in their descending order of frequency of occurrence in string S. So we want to find the number of characters in the string and the frequency of it, and we need to sort in the descending order. Okay, for example, if we take banana, B appeared 1, A appeared 3 times and N appeared 2 times, and we need to print in the descending order. So descending order of what? Occurrence. Okay, descending order of frequency of occurrence. So descending order means first we need to print A, and then we need to print B, and then we need to print N. So hope you got the program right, what we are going to do. So let's understand the logic, and then we'll write a program. So in order to solve this program, so this is the string we are taking, banana. Okay, so here we need to track the character and its count. For that, the easy way would be to take a hash map. Okay, take a hash map, and key is the character and value is the count. Check whether the character is in the map or not. If the character appears in the map, okay, if the character is present in the map, leave it. I mean, add. If the character is not present in the map, add the character to the map. So for example, first start will split the string into the character array, or we'll extract each character from this string and check whether it is present in the map or not. First check B is present in the map or not. No. So add B to the map, and then count will be 1 time it appeared. And check A is present in the map or not. Yes, A is not present in the map. Add A to the map, and the count will be 1. And then check whether N is present in the map or not. So N is present in the map. N is not present in the map, add N to the map. And then again check whether A is present in the map or not. Yes, A is present in the map. Get the value of this A and increment by 1. So when we say get of A, it will give you the 1. And then add one more time. Okay, increment, if already it is present in the map, increment by 1. Next check N is present in the map or not. Yes, N is present in the map, increment count by 1. Check A is present in the map or not. Yes, A is present in the map, increment the count. If it is not present, just add it to the map. If it is present, increment by 1. Now if you see, N is present 2 times, A is present 3 times, B is present 1 time. A is 3 times, B 1 time, and N 2 times. Now we need to sort in the descending order as per frequency. So now A will be printed, and then N will be printed, and then B will be printed. For that, what we can do is, we can use the comparator, and in the comparator, what we can do is, based on the value, we can compare the count, and then whatever the values with the highest frequency, that will be at the top, and the others will be printed later. Let's write the Java program and see the output. Okay, I have taken so here is the class. Public class sort demo, or just say print frequency, and then pickfix, and then rename compilation unit to print frequency, and now write a main method here. Okay, as I told you, first what we need to do, we need to create a hash map. Okay, first take the string which we have to find the number of occurrences. First create that string, and then create the hash map. So first let's create a string with the number of with the characters we need to find. String S equal to banana. Okay, and next what we need to create, we need to create hash map. So let's create hash map. What is the key? Character. What is the value? Integer. So hash map character comma integer, just say new hash map. Now let's add map dot Okay, first what we need to do, we have created a map. Now what we need to do, we need to iterate each character in the map, each character in the string. So for int I equal to 0, I less than s dot length, I plus plus, char c equal to s dot caret I. So this is not capital C, this is small c. So what is the purpose of this caret method? So first it will extract. So whenever we are looping, right, I mean in the for loop, first it will start with 0. So it will take s dot char at 0. That means it will extract the first character from the string, which is b, and then next character a, and then next character like this. So what is the purpose of caret method? So it returns the character value at the specified index. So an index ranges from 0 to length minus 1. So now we got the char c equal to s dot character at a. Now what we need to do is we need to take one integer and name it as value. Why? Because what we'll do is map dot will pass get key here. Okay, get of c. So get of c means what? C is nothing but this character, each and every character. So we'll take the, for that key, we'll check for that key there is any value or not. So that value will be holding here. We'll check in the map b is present or not. If b is present, we'll get the value. If it is not present, we'll get value as null. We'll check a is present or not. If a is present, okay, if a is present, what we'll get? We'll get the value as 1. Otherwise, we'll get the value as null. So now what we need to do is we need to check if value not equal to null, what we need to do? We need to add it to the map. So if value equal to not equal to null, map dot put of c comma, map dot put of c comma new integer of val plus 1, new integer of value plus 1. Else what we need to do, we need to add that value to the map. Map dot put of c comma 1. So with this we have completed the logic. What we need to do? We need to check whether the character is present in the map or not. If the character is present, okay, what we will do? We'll just increment the value. If the character is not present, what we will do? We'll add that character to the map and put the count as 1. So we got this now. Now what we need to do, the next one, we need to sort on the entry. Set of entry of character comma integer. Okay. Map dot entry set. Set of entry of character integer equal to map dot entry set. So entry set contains record. Okay, entry set contains what? So it will contain the row. It returns a set view of mappings contained in the map. So it will return a view of set. Okay, this is backed by the map. So what we will be doing is we'll convert this set to list now. Why are we doing all this? Because it will make the comparison easy. How do we compare in collections dot sort? I mean, in collections, there is a method called sort. For that sort, we need only list. So, but we cannot convert directly map to list. For that, what we are doing, we are converting map to set, and then we are converting the set to the list. So, how do we convert set to the list? So, we have a method. I mean, in the constructor, okay, just list of entry of character comma integer list equal to new array list of this. Okay, new array list of entry of character comma integer. Just do quick fix. So first what we have done, we have created a set by using map.entrySet, and then we have converted it to set. Now after convert, pass this set to this list. Okay, in ArrayList we have a constructor where we can pass the set to this list, and now we have list. Now what we are going to do is just say collections.sort. So if you see collections.sort, we can pass the list as well as the comparator here. Just pass the list and then add the comparator. So how do we write the comparator here? Just say collections.sort list and then new comparator of this. And here what we are going to do, we are going to pass map dot entry new comparator of map dot entry of character comma integer. Okay, there is one error. Let me see what is the error. Okay, here two openings, two closings, and here new map dot entry of character, and then two closes. Entry of character comma integer. Let me fix this. So here the issue is, let me show you. So here it is like this. Okay, earlier I have given character comma string here as well. I have removed that, and now this is the correct form. And if you see, now we are getting one more error. Let's fix it. So add unimplement methods. So whenever we are implementing comparator, we have to override this compare method. Here just say return o2.getValue o2.getValue.compare to o1.getValue. Okay, so this is how it looks. So finally we have sorted this list as well. So now what we are going to do is just print this list. So it will be based on the descending order only. Let's run this, let's write the for loop and iterate this list. So for entry of character comma integer, and then entry, and then list, sysout the frequency of currency of, here just pass plus entry dot get key, and then here just add this plus here. Why? Because there is double quotes, and here just give space entry dot get value. Let's run the program and see the output. You see the frequency of A is 3 times in banana, N is 2 times and B is 1 time. So hope you got the logic, right? What we are doing, first we are extracting each and every character in the map and check whether this value is present in the map or not. If it is already present, increment the count by 1. If it is not present, just add it to the map and put C comma 1. Now what we are doing, we are converting this map to set. Why? Because in collections.sort we have a list and comparator. So in order to sort the map by value, what we are doing is first we are converting it to set, and from set we are converting it to list. How do we convert it to list? By passing this set to the ArrayList constructor, we are creating a list. From this list, what we are doing, collections.sort list new comparator of map.entry character comma integer. And here the compare method is there, return o2.getValue.compare to o1.getValue. So finally what we are going to do, we are going to print the values in the list, character comma integer. So the frequency of occurrence of entry.getKey and entry.getValue. Okay, so print the key and value. So finally here we get the list with the sorted order by value, and finally we are printing the list. So hope you got this program right. So this is one of the program asked in the product based company today morning. So I have completed the test. So thanks for watching my video. If you want to learn these kind of programs, don't forget to join my Telegram group. I will be giving the link in the description. Join and try to learn as many programs as you want. Okay, thank you.